Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm going to discuss if-else statement in Java. So let's begin. So what is if-else statement in Java? Whenever you specify any condition in if, and if the condition evaluates to false, then what is executed? Else is executed. Here is the syntax of if-else. So here in if, you pass the condition. In if you are passing any condition and if the condition is not evaluated as true, then what is executed? Else part is executed. So whatever statement are there after else, that is going to be get executed. So now let's see flowchart of if else statement. So here you can see I have a Boolean expression. If the Boolean expression is evaluating as true, then whatever code we are having after if, that is going to get executed. If the expression is evaluated as false, then else part will be executed. And if any line is there after if else statement, then that line will get executed. So what I'm going to do now, I'm going to show you one example using IntelliJ IDEA. So now let me start IntelliJ IDEA and show you example of if else statement in Java. So I have started IntelliJ IDEA, I have created project also and declared one variable. And what is my aim? I have taken a very simple aim, that is what? Check whether the number is divisible by 5 or not. So if you want to check whether number, entered number is divisible by 5 or not, what is the logic? You have to use what? Divisibility operator, that is modulus operator. So before that, what I'm doing, I'm declaring one variable int n, and then I'm asking user to enter any number, and I'm reading that number and storing in a variable n. When the number is said to be divisible by 5, when you get remainder 0. So how to check whether remainder is 0 or not? We have an operator known as modulus operator. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to use that operator in my if condition. So I'm writing if n percent 5 is equal to 0. What does it mean? If you divide n by 5, you are getting remainder as 0. When you get remainder as 0, that means the number is divisible by 5. Similarly, you can check for divisibility of any of the number using this condition. So if it is divisible by 5, then what I'm going to print? I'm going to print divisible by 5. So I have printed n is divisible by 5. Now what if it is not divisible by 5, then what I'm going to print? I'm going to print it is not divisible by 5. If you are entering number which is divisible by 5, you are going to get this output. Otherwise, you are going to get this output. So I'm going to run this program. I'm entering number 10. So we should get 10 is divisible by 5. If I enter some other number, I am entering 12. So I am getting what? 12 is not divisible by 5. Similarly, you can use same concept for checking even or odd. So for that, you have to write 2 over here. So when we say a number is even, when it is divisible by 2. So if you write, if it is divisible by 2, then it is what? Even number. Otherwise, it is odd number. That's all for today's video. See you in my next video with a new topic, if, else part. Friends, if you have not subscribed to my channel, do subscribe it. And please share my video with your friends. And if you like my video, please hit the like button. And if you have any kind of queries or doubt, you can post in comment box. Thank you friends for watching my video till end. See you in my next video. Till that, bye bye and take care.